three or four years ago, you had one or two, maybe three strong teams. Now you've legitimately got five or six that are going to be vying for the four spots in the conference tournament. So we know what it's ahead of us. We know that we've got to play very well to compete within our conference. But if we play the way that we can, yeah, we can get to the conference tournament and hopefully get on a roll and win the conference tournament to get to nationals. We need to prove that we're one of the top teams in our conference. Yes, we're seeded number four right now, or pick number four, but to get to that one or two seed and get the bye in the conference tournament for that first round, yeah, that'll be a goal of ours. And I hope that I don't even have to mention it, once it really comes out and they understand where we're picked. Hopefully we can use it as momentum going into the season. Short term is really to get to know each other. We've got a couple of kids that are going to have to redshirt this year that leave some open spots for some younger players. And like I tell everybody, on our team, always expect to get in there. As coaches, we've got to put the players in the right positions. We've got to get our strongest defense and our strongest offense out there. On the long-term approach, our goal is to get into the conference tournament. Again, we know it's going to be tough. We know that softball-wise, our conference is very strong right now. And for us to qualify for the conference tournament will be a goal. Once we get to that conference tournament, again, then we want to win it. We want to be able to go in there and win three games and qualify for that national tournament, and then we get into the playoffs. We're excited to start the games. Then we go over to St. Mary's on a Tuesday night, and they're ranked number 12 in the nation in Division II. So we know what task is ahead of us. We've got to go over there and compete with them, and if things go our way, we can compete with them and hopefully pull an upset against them. Going into Cowtown, it's a great NAIA tournament. There's probably five or six top 25 teams in the preseason ranking that are there. So it'll be good for us to play a good non-conference schedule in that tournament itself. But we can always walk over and see Oklahoma City. We can see UHV play. We can see LSU UA play. We can see Texas Wesleyan play. And then, of course, we've got Shriner, Southwestern, Trinity, Calumet, and they're all solid non-conference opponents. So we don't have it easy. We don't have any easy games going into our conference schedule, and that's good for us. We hope that we stay healthy. Again, we should probably play upwards of 40 or 45 games prior to going to LSUA and prior to the UHV series. But again, all those, the Jarvis, Texas College, Southwest, Langston, we've got to prepare for them. We've got to know going up to Langston or having Southwest come down here, we've got to win those ball games. If we happen to have a hiccup or two against any of our opponents, then it takes some of the glamour off of those, high profile series at the end of the season. We really don't know what we have until we step on the field on Saturday, and then hopefully we'll come together and work as a group and get better.